Hey everybody, James here from Beaver Does Productions, back again with another daily movie review. And yes, I am back with another Netflix original, cross fingers it's hopefully a good one, as I checked out The Vault.
He's a college kid.
You're putting our lives in his hands.
Big problem.
Just stay until the job's done.
Get out! You're good.
The Vault is a 2021 heist movie. It is also known as Way Down, and is also known as Crying Game. It is a movie directed by John Balaguer, and it is starring Freddie Highmore, Astrid Burgess, Famke Janssen, and Liam Cunningham. And so this is a the thing that actually kind of brought my attention is that it was one of the top ones on Netflix at the time of this recording. And also, I did enjoy the idea behind the movie. This movie is set in 2010. It is around the time of the 2010 South African World Cup. And what happens is that Spain, where this movie is actually set, is in the finals. And so under the guise of the finals, while the game is playing, a treasure hunter hires a super intelligent engineer to help them find this treasure that was kind of taken from them by the Spanish government. And so it's pretty much a heist movie. It's pretty much if you've seen one heist movie, you've seen them all. And so like I said, the interesting backdrop is the South African World Cup. I did really enjoy that, because it was interesting. It really does feel like when they put this together, they pretty much had the idea for the ending where, spoiler alert, Spain win the World Cup. It was 11 years ago, calm down. And so what happened was, from there, Spain wins the World Cup, and so they managed to get away because everyone's too busy celebrating while the soldiers are trying to chase them down. And then we get the whole sequel bait bullshit at the end, which I can't see this happening again, but you never know. Like, it is top rated on Netflix, so maybe they will ask for a second one set in the 2012 Olympics. So, you know, maybe that's their whole thing, is to set it during like world events and stuff like that. Maybe a pandemic one, probably, who knows. But the one thing I did enjoy was the problem-solving aspects. I did like the way that they set it up, and that it was kind of logical in certain aspects. There's no super technology to help them or anything like that, because the safe that they're trying to break into was made in the 70s. So they have like interesting ideas, and I did enjoy that. Going into what I didn't like, if you've seen one heist movie, you've seen them all, and you've probably seen this movie quite a bit. It's very formulaic. It's all about the team. And talking about the team, the chemistry between the team is almost non-existent. It's kind of been pushed to the wayside for the two main characters, which is Freddie Highmore and Astrid. And those two kind of don't have chemistry. I really did like Astrid in this movie. I like the way she presents herself. She's like a master of disguise. She's the one that goes to scope out and figure things out. I like that. Liam Cunningham is pretty much his character, and he's pretty much, you know, Jorah. I can't remember who his character in Game of Thrones is. Comment down below if you remember who Liam Cunningham is in Game of Thrones. That last season took me out of it, and I think I've purged my memory of every single character from that series, but it is what it is. But he's pretty much his character in that he was you know, kind of leading everything like that. He's gruff, he's tough and stuff like that. Famke Janssen is in this briefly as kind of a antagonist in a way, but she's set up to be maybe be the main antagonist in the second one. Her English accent is not good. Take it from a British person. I know. So, but like, just despite all my shit talk about this, I did come away going, that was better than I expected. I came in this with zero expectations. Also, Freddie Highmore. Can you stop? Like, I really do think he's typecast himself as playing this socially awkward, be it, you know, mental health or anything like that. But he's a genius in other aspects. You know, like the good doctor in this, you know, Bates Motel, you know, stuff like that. He kind of paints himself as with that, which is, it's kind of annoying when you see someone who does have talent, but he just seems to just pick the same stuff over and over again. And as for my review, I'm going to give this two blanks. I think it started off boring. I find myself like checking my time, but I did enjoy when it actually got to the heist part of it. And there's also a character I really enjoy. He's a fan of Spain, the national football team, and he's just generally upset that he can't make the game. Even so, that he actually brings a radio with him on the heist, and you see him celebrating when Spain win. So, if you want, definitely check it out. It's okay. It's passable. If you do enjoy heist movies and you want to see something a bit different, this one could be good for you. If you like Freddie Highmore, that's also something for you as well. So yeah, check it out, and I will catch you guys tomorrow. Make sure you subscribe to the channel if you want daily movie reviews. A like is also fantastic. Also, if you've seen this movie and you want to throw some comments, I would definitely love to chat to you guys. Stay safe, and I'll see you tomorrow.